Hello, I'm Dheeraj, and I'll be talking about how to build your own desired state API for Citrix JDK. Let's first see what exactly is the desired state. To understand the same, we have to look into programming paradigms, imperative and declarative. The imperative paradigm is more of a procedural approach. Here, stepwise instructions are provided in order to get the end result or the finished product. Like in the first step, you should do this, then that, after that this, and blah blah blah, etc. And this is how you will be getting the end result. Declarative paradigm is more of a functional approach. In these kinds of programs, you are provided with input and you are told what should be the output. Here, user wants results and doesn't care about how you do things to achieve that desired end result. In short, imperative is about how and declarative is about what. Desired state belongs to the declarative school of thought. Desired state means declaring the expected end result or the final output. So why this desired state is desirable? As we just talked, user does not need to give any explicit instructions. She just needs to get the job done. It is a simpler life for user. Cloud native world like Kubernetes and other DevOps technologies prefer this declarative way. And customers are really happy in such a declarative world. Okay, all sounds very nice, but why should a developer and DevOps guy care? Industry is migrating rapidly towards cloud-based technologies such as Kubernetes, Istio, AWS, Terraform, etc. And many solutions, including free and open source ones, they are available in abundance, but these solutions might not necessarily satisfy all the requirements of the customer. Say you have a very big customer, important one, who is facing a $1 million problem and it is ready to shell out few bucks to get customized solution, a solution which is primarily solving its own use case. Needless to say, such a solution should be scalable, manageable and of course automated one. We can use desired state principle while developing such a solution. Software built with desired state principle is preferred by users as they just need to tell what you want. It makes our software smart and intelligent enough for users and they can achieve the nirvana. Let's now see how one should architect programs built on desired state principle. Your software should comprise of primarily three modules. First one is comparator, which constantly checks for the differences between current state of the system against the desired state. Second one is planner, which is responsible to create an execution plan like what should be deleted, updated, added, like CRUD plan, so that the current config can be converted to desired config. And third one is the committer, which applies the CRUD plan on the device so as to bring current state equal to the desired state. This program accepts two inputs, desired config, usually from the control planes management server, which tells what should be the end state of the system, and then obviously the current state of the system. Let's understand the workflow of such a system. Imagine you have a juice maker tool which maintains a list of juices. In the setup, we do have a control plane which has a management or API server like Kubernetes API server. Admin applies a bunch of YAML files to deploy new applications. In this case, adding and deleting few juices in the shop. Control plane server just gives the list of fruit juices which should be available to MyJuiceMaker. Now, MyJuiceMaker has received the desired state and it needs to get the current state. So it retrieves the current state of the system and then compares both the current state and the desired state. That is our comparator module. It then creates an execution plan as to which fruit juice should be kept as it is and which should be removed and which should be added. This is our planner. And finally, there is a committer which applies this CRUD plan to get the current state equal to the desired state. Okay, so that has been one stupid example. But now I will talk about the real world use case. We had a problem about deployment of Citrix JDK in Istio Service Mesh. Istio is an open source service mesh platform that provides a way to control how microservices communicate with each other. It comprises of control plane and data plane. The data plane handles network traffic between services in the mesh. All of this traffic is intercepted and redirected by a network proxying system. Citrix ADC is obviously a reputed proxy solution, and we wanted to deploy the same in data plane of Istio. Istio uses a bunch of discovery service APIs to find various dynamic resources in the system. Collectively, these are called as XDS, but Citrix ADC uses RISC-based Nitro APIs for configuration. So it was not exactly instantly possible for us to place Citrix ADC in the Istio data plane. When a service is deployed in Istio, the state of the system changes. The Istio control plane that comprises of XDS server sends the current state of the system to data plane. So Citrix ADC deployed in this environment needs to be configured appropriately according to the desired state of the overall system. But there are two main challenges. One, Citrix ADC doesn't understand XDS protocol. And second, Nitro API affects only one ADC config entity such as LBV server. We need to have APIs which can affect a bunch of ADC config entities together. So, XDS compliance and desired state API support, these are two main problems we faced. We had two solutions. First one is to design Citrix ADC itself to be XDS compliant. It is a good long-term idea to have native XDS protocol support, but it is a time-consuming process. Moreover, it just solves the first problem of XDS compliance. We still need to have desired state API support. So, a second option is to have a custom solution. As part of that, we develop a microservice acting as a bridge between XDS server and ADC. We design our microservice to be XDS compliant and also implement desired state APIs to target both problems. It also has additional benefit of rapid development. Hence, we went ahead with the customized solution and developed a Citrix XDS adapter which can tag along nicely with Istio. Citrix XDS adapter is a microservice written in Golang that provides desired state API for Citrix ADC configuration. It is a gRPC client to the XDS server. Thus, it can talk to various technologies based on XDS APIs like Istio, Consul, Ambassador, etc. It receives XDS resources from XDS server and converts them into equivalent ADC config blocks. The set of these config blocks represent the desired config on ADC. XDS adapter then commits these desired config blocks on ADC using newly developed desired state APIs. These desired state APIs are developed using Go Nitro library. Go Nitro is a Go client for Citrix ADC configuration. You can find it on GitHub. This is the architecture of Citrix XDS adapter. It comprises of two main packages, ADS client and NS config engine. ADS client has two important modules, XDS client and config adapter. XDS client module is responsible to establish gRPC connection with XDS server. It receives various XDS resources from the server like LDS, RDS, CDS, EDS, etc. Config adapter module converts these resources to a bunch of ADC config blocks. These config blocks represent the desired state. Config adapter sends desired state blocks to NS config engine. NS config comprises of desired state committer that is built on top of Go Nitro. It affects the desired state of an object on Citrix ADC. Let us see how desired state is obtained on ADC. Assume this is the current state of the system. We have Istio control plane and data plane. Citrix ADC and XDS adapter are part of data plane. And we have Apple and Banana services deployed in the service mesh. Now user deploys a new application Orange. XDS server in control plane dictates what should be the end result in the form of XDS resources, that is the desired state. XDS adapter now gets the current state of the ADC, that is it receives running configuration of ADC. ADC tells adapter that it has a config present for Apple and Banana. Adapter compares current state versus the desired state, that is our comparator module, and creates an execution plan like what should be added, deleted, updated, how to adjust old config to desired config. In this case, adapter determines that it needs to create config blocks for adding Orange service. That is the planner stage. In committer stage, apply this execution plan. We use a desired state API add for affecting the necessary entity configs on ADC. That is the committer stage. And eventually, our Orange service is up and running. We have developed desired state APIs for load balancer config. So using LB API, we can affect LB vServer, service groups, SSL vServer, policy, action, certificate and keys, all using one API call. We have API for service group members that binds all instances of a particular service or a list of IP and port endpoints to the service group. Desired state API for CS affect configuration for CS objects like CS vServer, SSL vServer, policy, action, certificate keys of the associated object. And then we have one more API for CS bindings that bind CS policies and actions, rewrite policies and actions, responder policies and actions to CS vServer. Let's have a sneak peek into the code now. Citrix XDS adapter is an open source and it is available on GitHub at this location. Let's have a look at CS APIs. This is the add API. As input, it takes information about name of objects which needs to be created, IP and port information for CS vServer, what should be the type of vServer, whether SSL, HTTP, TCP or anything, and some SSL specific information, etc. Now observe this add API. In this add method, we are creating various config entities such as CS vServer, ACLs. ADC has secure by default nature and it blocks communication to all ports. So ACL ensures to allow traffic only when it is needed. We create SSL vServer if required. We create LB vServer and CS vServer, LB vServer binding, etc. So all these things are done in just this one API call. Let me just give you a glimpse of this doNitro method. Inside this, we have one commit function. This commit function is a wrapper over APIs which are provided by goNitro. So this add resource, update resource are the APIs in the goNitro library. Here we have imported this goNitro package. Likewise, in delete API, we fire a bunch of delete calls for relevant config entities like ACL, SSL entities, bindings for the CS vServer, and finally CS vServer. We ensure a proper rollback to maintain the sanity of the ADC configuration. Let me show you one glimpse at our service group API also. So in service group API, we do have add method and then we'll be having the delete method also. This service group API, it has a name which should be the name of the service group and a list of members. These members are IP and port or a domain name which are bound to the service group as service group members. Now let us check this function. Here we are creating server entity for every IP and port. So we are actually looping through this list of members and creating this server. This is add operation here. And we are creating a service group and service group member binding. Now let us have a look at this function. We know that XDS server has provided us a list of endpoints, that is the desired state. So we look through each member and we create server entity on the ADC and relevant service group and service group member binding for each entity. Now this is the desired state. After that we do a get operation, like we do get the current configuration on the ADC using this call find resource array. Once we get all the service group member bindings, now we have the current state of the ADC and the desired state of the ADC. So we have the comparator plan in place, and now we actually make sure what entities need to be deleted. So basically we'll be like getting rid of all those endpoints which are no more part of the running system. So this loop will take care of like finding such configuration and deleting the same. And after that, we just using this do nitro call, we do commit this kind of a configuration on our ADC. This way, we ensure that config on ADC holds good with the overall system state.
Okay, so much talking. Now let's have a look at demo of XDS adapter and Citrix ADC integration in Istio Service Mesh. My friend and colleague Subhash will guide you through this demo.
Thank you, Dheeraj. As Dheeraj mentioned, I'll showcase the demo of XDX adapter and Citrix ADC CPX in Istio Service Mesh. Citrix ADC CPX is a containerized form factor of Citrix ADC, and Istio Mesh is deployed on Kubernetes cluster. I'm going to deploy a bookinfo application, which is equivalent of Hello World program in Istio World. The bookinfo application comprises of four services: product page, reviews, details, and ratings. All these services are written in different languages. Out of this, product page is the front-end service which accepts incoming requests to the bookinfo application. I would be deploying this application in bookinfo namespace. Each of these services will be installed with Citrix ADC CPX and Citrix XDS adapter as sidecar containers in the pod along with the application container. We have also deployed Citrix ADC as an ingress gateway separately, which controls the incoming request to product page pod. I have deployed Citrix ingress gateway also using Helm chart, but I won't go in detail about the installation of ingress gateway in the interest of time, and also it will be a big diversion from the topic in discussion. Let's deploy the bookinfo application. You can see here that product page and other services are running. Let me show you the pods that actually represents endpoints of these services. You can see that review services has three pods. This is because there are three versions of review service running. We'll talk about it later. Istio D, that represents Istio control plane, sends information about all services, endpoints, routing rules deployed in this mesh to all network proxies that are acting as a client to Istio D. This info is provided using XDS resources such as listeners, routes, clusters, and endpoints. Now let us have a look at logs of Citrix XDS adapter in any of the pods. Let me take the logs. Let me open this log file. We get many listener resources. Also, one of the listener resources obtained from Istio control plane. Now let's have a look at the log of a CS API add that is used for the desired state API for CS related entities. Here we are printing the contents of CS API structure that represents the input parameters for the add method. It comprises of CSV server name, CSV server IP, port, service type of the CSV server. If the service type of a CSV server is TCP, then the LVV server name. Just after this log entry, you can see below logs of Go Nitro library. Resource JSON represents the JSON payload provided in the Nitro call to the Citrix ADC. From these Go Nitro logs, you can see that we are creating CSV server, LVV server, and CSV server, LV server binding. Now let's check the configuration in CPX proxy. So you can see that there is a CSV server created for this, and there is a default target LV server created. Now let me show about CDS or cluster resources. Here we can see the traffic direction info of a particular service, what port the service is running. It also tells about the type of the service such as TCP, HTTP. This is the log from the ADS client package which Dheeraj talked about earlier. Related desired state API named LB API add for this cluster resource is present in NSConfig engine package. This log of LB API add shows the information about what LB server needs to be created if not already done, and if it is created then the same LB server is updated with the additional properties like LB method. It also creates service group with specified type like SSL or HTTP, and then we bind LB server with this service group. You can see this resource JSON payloads printed from Go Nitro here. If service group is of type SSL, so we will bind the relevant certificate key pair. Let's see the LB server configuration in CPX proxy for this. You can see there is an LB server and it is bound to a service group. Quickly, I'll also show the service group's desired state add API log. Here you can see that all desired endpoints of service group are listed here. Let's see the configuration in the CPX proxy for the service group API. You can see that the bound members of this service group are same as what provided to the XDS adapter. At last, I would just show one more desired state API, this time for CS bindings API, which is responsible to create CS policy and CS action. Now let's see the CS action and CS policy configuration in this CPX proxy. Now let me send a traffic to this book info application. I have exposed the front-end product page service via CPX ADC using node IP node port. This is the home page of book info application. As I said earlier, we have three versions of reviews running. Stars seen on this page are coming from the ratings microservice. If I do refresh, then color of stars should change or we should not see star itself. This represents that load balancing is happening between reviews service endpoints. Well, that's it from the demo side. I'll pass the baton to Dheeraj again.
Thank you very much, Subhash, for demoing this working example. Well, folks, that's it from my side also. In conclusion, I just want to reiterate that while developing software, particularly cloud native products, try to follow declarative programming paradigm as much as possible. You can provide desired state APIs for operations. This makes the life of API user simpler. Deployment YAMLs and Hemchart of book info example which Subhash demoed today are available on GitHub at the URL you are seeing on the screen. The XDS adapter is an open source software and the code is available on GitHub. Similarly, Go Nitro library is also available on GitHub. You are welcome to contribute to these projects. We will be glad to accept PRs. Thank you very much for tuning to this session. Have a good day.